Good afternoon and welcome to Sunday Sessions with me, Leigh Perry. You're listening to Solihull Radio.
Perry on Solihull Radio. cash back. Just give me six strings and a half stack. And you can keep the cars, leave me the garage. And all I need are keys and guitars. And it's within 30 seconds, I'm leaving to Mars. Yeah, we leaving across these undefeatable odds. It's like this, man, you can't put a price on a life. Nah, we do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So we ain't gonna stumble and fall, never. Waiting to see us in the sign of defeat. So we gon' keep everyone moving their feet. So bring back the beat, and then everyone sing.
It's not about the money.
The price tag.
Solihullradio.com.
Well, that was Price Tag and Jessie J. So welcome to the show. It's Sunday afternoon again. It's the 16th of September and I am Leigh Perry. I will be with you this evening until 6 o'clock on this Sunday Sessions. Joining me in the studio in a couple of minutes is Barry Birch. We'll be having a little chat about what's going on both in the local community and, of course, with Barry's music. Got loads of great music coming on during the rest of the show, including some Bruno Mars. We've got the Eagles. We've got country star George Dukas and a track from his new album. We've also got local singer and the voice contestant Carl Loxley. I've got one of his tracks. So loads to go to be getting on with. If you'd like to get in touch with us today, then all you need to do is you can call the studio on 0121 70 40 185. You can text us on 075 64 30 30 64. Or of course you can drop us an email, and that's studio@solihullradio.com. Little bit of music first of all, and this is Jess Glynn with Rudimental and These Days.
I know you moved on to someone new. Hope life is beautiful. You were the light for me to find my truth. I just wanna say thank you.
Leaving to find my soul. Told her I had to go. And I know it ain't pretty when our hearts get broke. Too young to feel this old, watching us both turn cold. Oh, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke. Yeah, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days, these days. All our troubles for it now. And I know it ain't pretty when the fire burns out. Calling me when I'm drunk, remind me of what I've done. And I know it ain't pretty when you're trying to move on.
Yeah, I hope someday we'll sit down together.
reminiscing on those past days. I thought you didn't know where my last name, but that changed. And I traveled around the world, think where you living at now. I heard you moved to Austin, got an apartment and settled down. And every once in a while, I start texting, write a paragraph, but then I delete the message. Think about you like a pastime. I could cry you a river, get you baptized. Or I wasn't ready to act right. Used to always think I'd get you back right. They say that things fall apart. We were gonna move to Brooklyn, you were gonna study art. Love is just a tool to remind us who we are, and that we are not alone when we're walking in the dark.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days. All our troubles will let them rest. We'll wish we could come back to these days. We'll wish we could come back to these days.
Leigh Perry on Solihull Radio.
I promise to take you as you are.
the amazing voice of the Rag and Bone Man, and that track was called As You Are. So, right in front of me here in the studio at Solihull Radio, I have Mr. Barry Birch. Good afternoon, Barry.
Good afternoon, how are you?
I'm okay, how are you?
Yeah, good, thanks for having me.
Welcome back.
Oh, thanks. Good to be back.
You came to the old studio, didn't you?
I did, yeah.
In the middle of winter?
Yeah, this is like central Solihull, this is amazing.
Isn't it great?
Yeah.
What a difference.
Fantastic.
I think you came in the snow, if I remember it rightly.
A bit slippy outside, just to get here.
Yeah. Just a bit. So you brought your son with you, Josh, who's sitting to my left, and hopefully we might get him to have a little talk later on. He looks very excited. But you, Barry, I mean, obviously you're an IT man at heart. That's your 9-to-5 job, is
that's
that right?
Yeah, absolutely. I've been working for a company called REPL for 4 years in IT in the daytime.
Okay, so that keeps you busy.
It does.
But of course, on the side, you're a music producer.
Yes, I'm quite addicted to producing music.
So tell us about that. How did that first start?
I've been producing music on PCs and for many, many years. And I've decided to do something official by being signed by a label called Pink Dolphin Records. And they released the music for me on iTunes and Spotify and everything. I've been working on some singles. But it really started, back in 1998, really, when I was 18 years old, just weekends, I just spend time on the PC making music and producing it, and always get songs in my head and ideas. Record them on cassette tape back in the day, and now it's on my phone.
Wow!
And you know, it's a bit of work to get them into making them into real songs, just ideas in your head. But it's definitely worth it.
And it's a particular type of music, isn't it? So it's synth pop or electro pop. What's the difference, or is it the same? One and the same.
Yeah. It's very much electronic music, which is known as electronic dance music, EDM.
Yeah.
And then you get different spurs off that. So whether that's techno or trance or house music, as people may know. And synth pop is very much 80s, like Depeche Mode, Human League, Kajagoogoo, Howard Jones, that kind of style of music. That's what I produce. And I'm looking to hopefully do some synthwave stuff, which is very underground. It's kind of like nostalgia, playing 80s synthesizers now, pretending that you're back in the 80s again.
Wow, and we've got some 80s tracks later on, actually. Right in front of me, I've got is this your new album now that I'm going to play this track three from?
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay.
So I'm doing a covers album. This is my third album. So I've got songs on there from Pet Shop Boys that I've covered, Gary Numan, Erasure, and track three is Simple Minds, Big Sleep.
Simple Minds, okay. But this is your voice, this is you singing, your production.
Yeah.
Fabulous, let's have a little listen.
So where did you go? Where do you go in the big sleep? Going out in the big sleep is where you're wandering now. So where did you go? When you're in the big sleep, drifting wildlife, and still you're wondering now who we were on the top and the wheel was spinning. We were on the yoke and the wheel full of warning. Communication lost in the thundering rainstorm, sheltered from the storm. In the early beginning, going out in the big sleep, out in the big sleep. Could have been years, you know it could have been years, oh, only seconds ago. That you up in the big sleep, valuable friend. So you leave me this way. We were on the top and the world was spinning. We were on the yoke and the world full of warning.
was a 1982 track from Simple Minds called The Big Sleep, covered by yourself, Barry Birch.
Yeah, that's right. Now I know Cyber Monday.
Cyber Monday, I was just going to say that. So that's your name, that's your artist name.
That's correct.
Okay, so you've got a new album coming out, which this is on. So why have you decided to do covers now as opposed to your own compositions?
Yeah, I did two albums. So I did like my own music with demos and that kind of thing, producing those. That was released last year, known as Store Credit. And then I did a remix album from the same tracks, known as Store Debit. So I've done two albums there. And really to get more promotion, really. It's really important for audience to relate to the music that I do.
Yeah.
And listening to covers that they can relate to really gets them introduced to myself.
Of course, yeah. It's easier to market, isn't it, as well?
Yeah.
I would have thought as well, it's a totally different style of music, so it's not for everybody.
No.
But it's massive, isn't it?
Yeah, actually? It is, yeah.
And it's getting bigger.
Yeah, like, for example, Soft Cell, there's Mark Elmond and Dave Ball. They've just released a box set.
Oh.
They're doing a massive, they're doing their final farewell tour at the O2 Arena in London. All of these synth pop bands are making a comeback.
Yeah.
And I was born in 1980. I grew up listening to all of these bands, and they keep in your head. And for example, the Simple Minds track that I covered that you just heard, I only heard that song about 2 months ago. Never heard it before. As soon as I find a band that I really like, I have to listen to every single track that they've done.
Yeah.
It becomes extremely addictive. But as soon as a song gets stuck in my head and it plays back for, say, 2 weeks every hour, it's almost like torture.
You're hooked.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you're absolutely hooked.
So that's, if I can relate that much to a song, that I have to cover it.
Exactly, you know. Exactly. Okay, well, we're going to be talking more about you and your music and what's going on with gigs and events, etc. But I do have to go in about 5 minutes' time to the phone lines. We've got a very angry local resident discussing who wants to come on the phone and just talk about what's happening with parking charges in Knowle. Barry, something we've been talking about off air.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to play a piece of music and then, we'll be talking to the resident. Also, if anybody would like to get involved, if you would like to put your your thoughts forward to us here at Solihull Radio, then just text us on 075 64 30 30 64 or call us on 0121 70 40 185. If that's if you are an owner of a shop in Knowle, you work in Knowle, or you just shop there and you want to get involved with the conversation, then do get in touch. First of all, this is a bit of Bruno Mars and this is Count On Me.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what we're made of, when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me, like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you, like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Tossing and you're turning and you just can't fall asleep, I'll sing a song beside you. And if you ever forget how much you really mean to me, every day I will remind you. Oh, find out what we're made of, are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me, like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you, like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh. Yeah. things are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, ooh. You can count on me, cause I can count on you.
Solihullradio.com.
That was Bruno Mars. You are with Solihull Radio. We are online and on demand. My name is Leigh Perry and I'm with you for Sunday sessions right the way through until 6 o'clock this evening. I should have, with a bit of luck, a lady called Kate on the phone. Kate, are you there?
Oh, I am here.
Oh, brilliant. Okay, so Kate, you got in touch with the studio because you're a local resident and I believe the charges to park are going to be changed at the end of September. Is that correct?
They're in Knoll, yes. I think it's in Solihull as well, but it's Knoll that I'm most cross about.
Okay, so I believe, I was just talking to Barry, because obviously you come into the village as well, Barry, quite a bit. I think originally that there were three hours that you had free parking.
Yeah.
And then I think they reduced that. I don't know whether that was last Christmas, but I think that was reduced to 2 hours. I'm not 100% sure. You've just sent me the link, actually, from Solihull Council website, that it's something like, if I'm right, Kate, here, that there's going to be, it's going to be reduced right down to half an hour. So you get half an hour free, which, let's face it, you can't get an awful lot done in half an hour. And, you know, you might forget as well. But I think you've got to put a ticket on anyway. So you've got free half an hour and then it's 20p for the next half an hour. So for up to an hour. And then I believe after that it's 40p. Is that right, Kate?
Yes, it is. And I think what you've just said is the principle of the matter, that originally parking in Knoll was free completely. And then they brought in 3 hours. Then it was 2 hours, and now it's half an hour. And the principle of the matter is, you know, in another 12 months' time, it will probably be, now it's 30p to park, or they'll take away the half an hour completely.
Yeah, and I mean, how often do you come into Knoll Village itself?
So I go into Knoll probably, well, at the moment, a minimum of once a week, sometimes twice a week. I come in on a Saturday regularly because I have music lessons. My music lesson is half an hour, so the half an hour free is no use to me because obviously I've got to get in, got to get parked, come have my lesson, then finish. So every week I'm going to have to pay 20p just so I can have my music lesson. And what annoys me the most about it is that time that I come into Knoll, I would normally come in, I'd meet people, I'd go for a coffee, go to the pet shop, go to the bookshop, go to the butcher's, go to Tesco, and all that's going to go because I'm not going to pay and just do those sort of casual things that I'm doing just because I'm coming for my music lesson. So all of those businesses are going to lose my money.
So is it the fact that, I mean, I think half an hour is ridiculous because I think you can't do anything. If you're going to meet somebody for a cup of coffee, by the time you've got in the queue and you've sat down and got your drink, then you've got maybe 15 minutes left. So I think half an hour is absolutely ridiculous. I mean,
yes,
should they?
They said they put the half an hour on so that people can drop off their children. But again, those people who are dropping off their children would perhaps afterwards go into Knoll and have a coffee or go around the shop. And they're just not going to do that anymore. So
yeah, that's a good point.
Is benefiting from this other than the council saying they want to make money.
Yeah.
But I honestly think people will walk with their feet. They'll just say, well, we're not going to pay. Dorridge is still free, so we're going to have a coffee in Dorridge instead. The businesses will suffer and they're going to be making barely a pound a day.
Yeah, it does seem a bit petty, doesn't it? I mean, I managed to get hold of a couple of the people that own shops in the village. One who completely agrees with you. Another one who's just pretty much said they don't know what all the fuss is about. You know, what's 20p, etc., etc. So there are people saying, you know, what's all the palaver about. I think that personally, I think, why didn't they just leave it as a free hour and then instead of maybe 40p then thereafter, make it a pound thereafter? I think just the whole 30-minute thing is a bit pathetic, don't you?
Yes, I would agree with that. And like you said, 20p, it's not going to break the bank, but it's the principle of the matter that the council have constantly gone, right, we'll give you three. No, we'll give you two. No, we'll give you half an hour.
Yeah.
And if we continue to pay it, they'll just keep reducing it. And the only way to object to what's happening is to walk.
Right. So have you gone as far as to contact the council or to try and speak to anybody there? Do you think people will bother or do you think people will just pay up and get on with it?
I don't think people will pay. I think some people might pay it and say, oh, it doesn't matter. But I think for the regular people, and we're talking about, you know, there's the older generation maybe that go into Knoll quite a lot during the week for social occasion, you know, to meet with people, have coffee. I just don't think they will. They'll go to Dorridge because it's still free. They'll go to other places that's free. And the businesses are going to suffer.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to see if we can keep this rolling maybe for the next couple of weeks, actually. It'd be good to get somebody on from the council, actually, and maybe some of the local shop owners as well, if they'd like to get involved. But, yeah, thanks, Kate, for your time and for coming on the show this afternoon.
That's no problem.
Keep us informed. Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
So that was Kate Rollison, obviously a local resident, talking about the parking charges. So, yeah, Barry, what are your thoughts on it?
I think 30 minutes is really tough, actually. I can imagine the community in Knoll just panicking, just absolutely running to their cars, rushing to get out the car park, potentially having more accidents. You know, what if somebody goes for a haircut, because there's lots of hairdressers in Knoll, you know, if there's a queue in front of them, they're going to be up in panic over this if they decide not to pay, and then they suddenly have to put in 20p and how many machines are they going to be? Are they going to improve anything? What if the machine's out of order? That, you know, it really does open a can of worms, I think.
It does. Actually, Kate made a good point. There are a lot of people I happen to know that will drop people off to us, for example, at the at the music school, and they go off shopping. Yeah. Or they will go, because we don't have a massive waiting area, they'll go to the pub and meet friends, or they'll go to one of the coffee shops on the high street. But 20p is nothing. That's the other point, isn't it?
Yeah. I just think it will affect the community in Knoll. And Knoll is known for a really proud community.
It's true.
And, you know, it's a very small village still. And those shops, they need the money. They need there's not a worse time, really, at the moment with the way that retail is going. I mean, look at John Lewis. They've lost in one year.
Yes.
99% profits in one year they've lost.
I know.
Compared to last year. So I think we're in for tough times. So I completely agree.
Well, I think... as well as that, I'm sure I was talking to you the other day that there are so many empty units already in Knoll.
Yes.
So I think there's about 7 empty units.
And that has a bigger impact than it would do in Solihull.
Yeah, of course.
There's still lots of vacant units in Solihull, to be fair. Yeah. But they're not as noticeable as one high street.
Do we know from what you've looked up on the site, do we know whether this is just daytime parking, or is it you have to pay as well after 6 o'clock at night, weekends? How does it affect?
I understand that it's still free on Sundays, but I don't know whether that changes, whether you still have to present a ticket or not. So there's so many questions that need to be answered.
Of course. I mean, I know I've got a guest coming on in, I think, the middle of next month, actually, who wants to talk about the Knoll Christmas shopping event. And also there's the Christmas, the lights,
yes.
You know, that evening. And I think that starts about 4 o'clock. So that's going to hit those people as well, you know, 4 till 6. So what does everybody think? Please let us know. Just drop us an email on studio@solihullradio.com or text us on 075 64 30 30 64. Okay, Barry, we're going to have a little bit more music. A gorgeous voice of Mr. George Michael. And I love this. This is One More Try.
Great.
I've had enough of danger.
to Solihull Radio. We are online and on demand, and I'm Leigh Perry. I'll be with you until 6 o'clock this evening. Barry Birch is with me, otherwise known as Cyber Monday, right here in the studio. Just made us a cup of coffee. Thank you very much.
You're
need
very
that.
Welcome.
We've had a text message in. I don't know who this is from, but it says, "Get Solihull." It's talking about the fees, the parking fees in Knoll, and it says, "Get Solihull Council to issue a yearly permit. Pay something like £50 a year and then the job's sorted." They've put also, which again, we were talking about this actually, we're paying 5p, aren't we, now for plastic bags? I mean, that's a pain, I think, especially when you keep forgetting. I've got hundreds in the cupboard at the home, in the kitchen. 5p, and I think they're putting that up to 10p from what I've heard on the news. So what's 20p for half an hour's parking? Yeah, I know, what's 20p? But it's just... I just think the elderly people, it's confusing as well. It's been one thing for so long, you know, and then they dropped it, then they changed it again. Now they're changing it again. You've got to have change in your purse. And I think some people will be completely confused. They won't know whether they've got to pay at the beginning or whether they've got half an hour to go and then they've got to come back and put 20p on. I just think a lot of people are going to end up with parking fines.
It's going to catch a lot of people out.
Yeah, they're not going to be able to plan what they're doing in advance. And also, just sometimes... I don't know, it's like today I've arrived here, quite organised, loads of time to spare. So what did I do? I've gone off around the shops. And I think if you've got time on your hands and it's not costing you, you spend more in the shops, don't you think?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah, it brings a lot more stress and it's the mindset that you've got to be in as well.
Yeah.
If you're in a rush, you're not going to enjoy yourself.
True. And the one thing I didn't realise actually, which has made me, because I was sort of saying to you, well, what does it matter? You know, what's 20p? Mm-hmm. I didn't know it was free in Dorridge.
No, that's a very good point.
I didn't realise that. But there's not many places to park, though, are there in Dorridge?
No, and I believe that Sainsbury's has reduced their time that's free as well. So, yeah.
But is it only free if you go and do a shop? In Sainsbury's, because I know where
yes,
I live in Hales Owen.
Yeah,
in Hales Owen, I think this is really good. They've actually done the opposite. They've done it in reverse, whoever the councillors are over in our area. We used to have to pay. They've now made all the car parks free for the first 2 hours.
Great.
They've reversed it, and then you have to pay, with the exception of the Asda car park, where you do have to pay. It's only 50 pence, but you get that back then if you spend £5 in store. So actually, I think, personally think, they're thinking on their feet.
Yeah.
I think they're thinking about business people.
Yes.
And I think for Knoll, they're considering the money they're going to get in initially. They're not particularly considering the shop owners, are they?
I mean, the only positive that I can possibly think about at the moment is that there'll be more spaces in Knoll. But I've never struggled to park, to be fair.
No. Except for when they're all clocking out of school about 3 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to have a bit more music and then we're going to come back and talk about your music, Barry. Get in touch, everybody. If you'd like to get involved, just text us on 075 64 30 30 64. I've also got a bit of a challenge a little while. First of all, this is Mika and Grace Kelly.
I want to talk to you.
The last time we talked, Mr. Smith, you reduced me to tears. I promise you it won't happen again.
Do I attract you? Do I repulse you with my queasy smile? Am I too dirty? Am I too flirty? Do I like what you like? I could be wholesome, I could be loathsome, guess I'm a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me without making me try?
I try to be like Grace Kelly, but all her looks were too sad. Tried a little Freddy. I've got an entity mind. I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet, I could be red, I could be black, but I could be anything you like. Gotta be green, gotta be mean, gotta be everything more. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me? Why don't you walk out the door?
I'm not afraid to die.
Ching. I love that. Mika. He's got a high voice, Barry, hasn't he?
Higher than me.
Where's he gone? Actually, I love Mika, and he seems to have disappeared off the face of the earth. I don't even know where he's from, do you?
No, sorry.
No. So, Barry Birch is with me in the studio, otherwise known as Cyber Monday. We just played one of the tracks that will be on your upcoming album. It's going to be out there, isn't it? And you can get it on all platforms like...
That's correct. Like Spotify. iTunes. I think that's a hard part for artists now is to make money, you know.
Yeah.
Because of the internet, everybody streams music now on Spotify, and it's you know, if you get like 10,000 streams and plays of a song, you might get like 20p or something. Mm. That'll pay for the parking in Knoll.
It will.
But, you know, for
just
now.
About. Won't get you a coffee, but there you go. I don't know how it works these days, because obviously you can still get hard albums. You can go to a store and you can buy them, but if you can also get them on iTunes or whatever.
Yes.
How does it affect those sales? Do you know how that works?
Yeah, and there's a really good website called bandcamp.com, and it's where music artists go to now, because they can put their own merchandise on the website.
Right.
So some people release on cassette. I've done that myself. But the great thing about buying the cassette is that you'll also get a download of the high quality music at the same time.
Okay.
So you get the best of both worlds. You get something tangible, mm-hmm. Like vinyl or CD. And then you also get the songs. And I think that's the best way forward.
True. I still love to have the actual CD. Yeah. I don't know why. Something about it, isn't there? I have to say, those everybody that's listening, thank you for listening in this afternoon. We did, as you know, Barry, we were talking before we went on air. We had award-winning businesswoman Sally Eaves joining us this afternoon. Due to terrible circumstances, unforeseen circumstances, she can't make it in today. So Sally Eaves won't be with us this afternoon. But we have rescheduled, and she will be with me on September the 30th, which I believe is not next Sunday's show, but the following weekend she will be here then. And she's got an exclusive reveal to tell everybody about. So I'm really excited about that. But in the meantime, we have Barry with us, Cyber Monday. I'll hopefully play another one of your tracks in a little while. What's your kind of taste in current music, Barry?
Oh, it's very varied. But I'm not very mainstream. I mean, I did get, what, the Now 100 compilation, and I was quite disappointed, actually.
You're like two.
I'm two 80s. I think that's my problem.
80s?
Really.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Far too 80s.
So you like my opening track then,
oh,
Abracadabra.
Yeah. That was brilliant.
So that you've got a few facts on that, haven't you?
Yeah, that's right.
1982.
Yes, it got to number one in the US
right.
for 2 weeks on the Billboard charts.
Okay.
Got to number two in this country. I don't believe it was released on CD back then.
Oh, no, I don't think it was, actually.
No.
I just loved it back then. Mm-hmm. Do you like country or not?
I do. I'll be honest. I do like a full mix of music.
Yeah, me too. I like most music. Well, this next singer that I'm going to be playing his track right now is called George Dukas. I have to confess that I hadn't heard of him before we met on Twitter. And I've got some of his tracks, absolutely love them. And he's been really great, actually. And he's posted me his brand new CD that's only been released about a week over from America. So I love this song. This is called Lipstick Promises. And this is country star George Dukas.
Thank you.
on Solihull Radio.
Baby girl, I said tonight is your lucky night. Peter Andre along with my blog and Spani Mike.
I stop and stare at you, walking on the shore. I try to concentrate, my mind wants to explore. The tropical scent of you takes me up above.
That's only Peter Andre and Mysterious Girl. So I need to tell you, for the very last time, you can enter a talent contest, which is taking place next weekend. That's September the 23rd. It's called Search for a Star. If you can sing or dance or play a musical instrument, or you're in a band and you would like the opportunity to perform at Symphony Hall in Birmingham next April, next spring, then get in touch and email this address. It's not the studio here, it's called onstagenext@gmail.com. So drop an email to onstagenext@gmail.com. Anybody can enter, any age group. Just if you've got talent, then get in touch. Okay, I've got lined up here a track from a friend of mine, Richie Sampson. He's from the award-winning Soul and Motown band, Soul Kinda Wonderful. They're going to be performing at the Courageous Kids Awards on the 10th of November at Edgbaston Cricket Ground. Have a listen to this.
I look in the mirror, yesterday comes back.
Richie Sampson and his album Tears at the End of a Love Affair. I love that, actually. That's great. Thanks, Richie. If you're listening, could you send me your own composition, the one that you've written for the Courageous Kids Awards? I'd like to play that next Sunday, if possible. So, yeah, Richie will be appearing at the Courageous Kids Awards on the 10th of November. I'll be there. It's a great charity. It's a great night, actually, supporting all of these kids and also performing. So it's a really good lineup. We've got Kyle Passmore. He was, you'll know him from being on the Gary Barlow show that was called Let It Shine. I think that was about 18 months ago on BBC One. Local Birmingham singer-songwriter Jake Maddox is performing. And of course, Richie that you've just heard there. So it's going to be a really good night. That's the Courageous Kids Awards on the 10th of November. So with me in the studio, as you know, we have Barry Birch, better known as Cyber Monday. In his music career, and with him is Josh. Josh is his son, and we're going to get Josh to just say a few words in a minute. But Barry, you've got this new album coming out in October, and it's called Under the Covers. So where did you get the title from?
Oh, I made it up.
Just randomly made that up.
Yeah, I did. No, I thought it was a good ring to it, actually.
Yeah.
So yeah, I've covered songs like Simple Minds, Big Sleep, which you've heard, Together in Electric Dreams by Phil Oakley.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, I've got Gary Newman, Cars, Erasure, I've done a PhD song, I Won't Let You Down.
Oh, okay.
And a Ronnie song. Ronnie's quite an unknown artist from the 80s, early 80s, synth pop artist, To Have and Have Not, which is another song. And then the other track that I've done is Pet Shop Boys, Say It To Me, which Josh helped me on the vocals with that.
Ooh, yep. Hi, Josh.
Hello.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Yeah.
You're going to be our new assistant. I could do with a producer on a Sunday afternoon.
Maybe.
Can you make coffee?
Yeah.
Perfect. You're booked. So, Barry, what did Josh do and how did he get involved with being on the album?
Yeah, I went to a recording studio in Digbeth, which is fantastic, actually. I have to say, it's where you can hire per hour. Josh came along with me. He's always been interested in my music. He's always had a good passion for it, always loved the tracks that I've made. So yeah, I said, did you want to come along? It's quite lonely on your own going to the studio. So Josh came with me, and he could hear in the background that I was doing the Pet Shop Boys song, and I really struggled with one of the high notes.
Right.
And Josh says, yeah, do you want me to help? Do you want me to have a go? I said, yes, please. And he ended up doing the backing vocals for me on the track. So yeah, I was dead proud.
Oh, it's exciting, Josh.
It's fantastic.
Are you looking forward to hearing that when that comes out? Have you told all your mates at school?
No, not really.
Why not?
I'm waiting till it comes out, really.
Are you going to surprise them?
Well, they're just probably going to hear it.
Are they? So you enjoyed it? Enjoyed being part of it?
Yeah, I actually did.
Brilliant. So we're going to get to hear it then next time?
Yeah, sure.
Come back, yeah, mm-hmm. When it's released.
Yeah, of course.
Have a listen to it. Fantastic.
Thanks.
Maybe I'll get your autograph then, Josh.
Star in the making.
Absolutely. Okay, a bit more music, shall we? So it's 5:10 already. Where does the time go when you're enjoying yourself? Yeah. Okay, this is Stereo Hearts, Gym Class Heroes.
My heart's a stereo. It beats for you, so listen close. Hear my thoughts in every note. Oh, oh. Was meant for you,
yeah, right,
so sing
there.
Along to my stereo.
Gym Class Heroes, baby. If I was just another dusty record on the shelf, would you blow me off and play me like everybody else? If I asked you to scratch my back, could you manage that? Like if we had chicken travy, I can handle that. Furthermore, I apologize for any skipping tracks. This is the last girl that played me, left a couple cracks. I used to, now I'm over that. Cause holding grudges over love is ancient artifacts. If I could only find a note to make you understand, I'd sing it softly in your ear and grab you by the hands. Keep me stuck inside your head like your favorite tune. And know my heart's a stereo, the only place for you.
My heart's a stereo, it beats for you, so listen close. Hear my thoughts in every note.
Yeah, yeah, come on.
Make me your radio, and turn me up when you feel low. This melody was meant for you, so sing along to my stereo.
Let's go! If I was an old school 50 pound boombox, would you hold me on your shoulder wherever you walk? Would you turn my volume up in front of the cops and crank it higher every time they told you to stop? And all I ask is that you don't get mad at me when you have to purchase Mad D batteries. Appreciate every mixtape your friends make. You never know, we come and go like on the interstate. I think I finally found a note to make you understand. If you can hit it, sing along and take me by the hand. Just keep me stuck inside your head like your favorite tune. You know my heart's a stereo, the only place for you.
It beats for you, so listen close. Hear my thoughts in every note. Make me your radio and turn me up when you feel low. This melody was meant for you, so sing along to my stereo. Cause good music can be so hard to find.
So hard to find.
I'll take your hand and hold it closer to mine.
Yeah.
They tried to make me go to rehab. I said no, no, no. Yes, I've been black, but when I come back, no, no, no. I ain't got the time, and if my daddy thinks I'm fine, they tried to make me go to rehab. I won't go. Seventy days.
Leigh Perry on Solihull Radio.
There we go. That was a bit of Amy Winehouse. You're listening to Solihull Radio, and I'm with you until 6 o'clock. I'm Leigh Perry. It's 17 minutes past five. And I've just had a message on Twitter, actually, from Be Proud Warwickshire. Thank you for this information. You can provide us with information every week. That'd be great. This is about Mika, actually. I was just saying how much I love Mika and that he seems to have disappeared. I used to play his album all the time. So they've sent me this message to say Mika was born Michael Holbrook Pennyman Jr. on the 18th of August in 1983, stylized as Mika, and he's a Lebanese born English recording artist and singer songwriter. He's fabulous. I love his music. Okay, just a nice ballad, I think. I've got a nice ballad lined up here, and it's not just any old ballad. It's from an incredible local artist called Carl Loxley. And Carl is from Borsal Common, and he was actually in The Voice, I don't know what year, a couple of years ago. He actually got into Tom Jones's team, did really well, and he's doing fantastically now. He's off on the cruises and he fills theatres. And I'm really excited to say that he's going to be performing on my show, Symphony Hall, next April. I think he's doing three numbers. He's doing one from Les Miserables, one from Phantom of the Opera, and this next track, this is absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you. la fantasia es tu vento caldo che soffia sulle città come amico. Lo sogno ad anime che sono sempre libero.
That is actually Nella Fantasia, also known as Gabriel's oboe from the film The Mission. So switching over now, you get everything here at Solihull Radio, from a bit of classical to a bit of rock. Free and All Right Now. So we were talking a little bit earlier to a lady called Kate on the phone, who's up in arms about the new charges that are going to be coming into Knoll from, I think, the end of this month. I've actually had another text message off somebody called Simon, who Simon has said that he was thinking about buying a business in Knoll, but he's worried at the moment about the footfall after the changes, and is actually looking elsewhere. So that's not good news. Yeah, you need to tell us what you think, and we'll keep this rolling over to next weekend and see if we can maybe get somebody to comment from the council. Just get in touch with us directly here at Solihull Radio. You can text 075 64 30 30 64. You can call us on 0121 70 40 185. Or you can email studio@solihullradio.com. You're listening to Solihull Radio online and on demand. I'm Leigh Perry, and I'll be with you until 6 o'clock this evening. Got another ballad lined up for you now. This is Celine Dion and Live for the One You Love.
Stars light this beautiful night. This is not a night to die. Let me sing and dance beneath the sky. I have such love to give, to give. I want a chance to live. In return, free to find my way, free to have my say, free to see the day. All of life in me. Still together in my heart, I want the world to hear my cry. And even if I have to die, love will not die. Love will change the world.
Celine Dion and Live for the One I Love. So with me in the studio, I've got Barry and I've got Josh. I've just discovered something about you, Josh. I didn't know you were a YouTuber.
Yep.
What do you do on YouTube?
So mainly like game and stuff.
Okay. And how many subscribers have you got?
I think around about 16 or 17.
Fantastic. Okay, it gets better and better. Well, I've got a challenge in about 10 minutes time which you can join in on. Anybody that's listening, I'm going to play a track in a little while, about 10 minutes, and if you're listening in, I want you to dance around the lounge, the kitchen, wherever it is that you are, and get somebody in the house to video you, and then you're going to email it in to studio@solihullradio.com. So get ready in about 10 minutes' time. But lined up before that, I've got a little bit more rock today. We were just talking about this artist, Barry. Meatloaf.
Oh, yes.
What's the classic track? This is Dead Ringer.
Dead Ringer, that's it.
Dead Ringer for Love.
Rolling through a low, baby, baby, rock and roll it through.
This is the Eagles, currently the best-selling album of all time in the US. It's actually knocked Thriller off the top notch. This is New Kid in Town.
Everybody's watching you. People you meet, they all seem to know you. Even your old friends treat you like you're something new. Johnny come lately, the new kid in town. Everybody loves you, so don't let them down. You look in her eyes, the music begins to play. Hopeless romantics, here we go again. But after a while,
Solihull Radio.
So that was the Eagles, and we now have the dance challenge coming up. So Josh, get into place, and anyone that's listening out there, Tracy, are you listening? You were on the Solihull Radio dancing in the kitchen before. So what I want everybody to do that's listening in this afternoon is get somebody to video you dancing to this next track. Barry, you'll remember this one. This is Papa's Got a Brand New Pig Bag. Remember that track clearly, Barry, do you?
I do, yeah.
It's a bit odd in the middle, isn't it? Goodness me. I'm not quite sure about the saxophone solo, but there we go. Oh, it's worn me out just listening to that. So what have you got going on in the not-too-distant future, Barry? You've got the album coming out in October.
Yes, I want to start doing
really
some
exciting
synthwave stuff, so very more instrumental stuff, more guest vocals.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to do that next, I think.
Okay, so it's just an ongoing project.
Absolutely.
And how was your gig? Because when you came on last time, I think it was in March,
yes.
April, you got a gig coming up in July, was it?
Yeah, it was great.
In Birmingham, yeah.
There were a few, it was in Digbeth.
Right.
I believe that venue's closed down now.
Has
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
Gosh.
Next door to the Glee Club. And yeah, but no, it was a good gig. It was good to get my myself on stage again.
Yeah, excellent. Okay. And thank you, Josh, as well. Are you all right? You're very quiet over there. Right, we are running rapidly out of time. I've got about three more songs to get in. I'd just like to play this Michael Bolton one. Just calm the mood down just a little bit for this Sunday afternoon.
But I made up my mind I'll get through. Yeah, I'm gonna learn to carry on now, 'cause I'm determined to be strong now. Don't worry, it's gonna be alright. Don't worry, it's not the end of my life.
Dancing up the ocean, running fast
along the sand. A spirit born of earth and water, fire flying from your head. Up your spine, and the peace is finally fed. And all I ever needed was the one, like freedom feels where wild horses run. When stars collide, like you and I, those shadows. When chances breathe between the silence, where sex and love no longer jail. Oh, for each man in his time is king. Like
the amazing Elton John and the one from his album Love Songs. So that's it. I'm nearly out of time today, this Sunday afternoon. I'd just like to thank everybody for joining me. Many thanks to my guests, Barry Birch and Josh, here in the studio. Thank you for coming in.
Oh, thank you.
We'll see you again, and good luck with the album. I also like to say I'm sorry for those of you who were waiting for my interview with Sally Eaves today. Due to unforeseen circumstances, she couldn't join us in the studio, but she will be here on the 30th of September. So enjoy the rest of your weekend. Next Sunday in the studio, it's Psychic Sunday, and joining me will be Beth Leigh Crowther, author and animal communicator. In the meantime, I'm going to finish off with another Bruno Mars track, and this is Locked Out of Heaven.
On Solihull Radio.